Howdy guys, it's Liv here from Neighbourhood. Have you ever considered using HubSpot to fine-tune your social media game? Perhaps you're already using HubSpot but want to post and track your engagement across all of your social media accounts. Well, this is where HubSpot's social tool comes into play, and we're going to show you exactly how to create and schedule a social post today, along with some best practices. Now remember, if you're keen on learning more with us, Neighbourhood actually offer a comprehensive and easy to follow course so that you're making the absolute most out of your HubSpot investment. Stay tuned for more information at the end of this video. As well, if you want to take your learning offline, we'll also include a downloadable PDF in the description below for how we did this today. Okay guys, so here we are inside the social media tool. You can see in here in our test account that we've just got some dummy posts that we've created in here, but you can see across the top that we're currently inside the Manage tab. I'm sure that we'll have other videos on our account soon about how you can use the Monitor and Analyze tabs to keep on top of your social media output and ensure that everyone from your team is on the same page about what's coming up social-wise. However, today let's have a look at just creating a social post. Now, as always, you're going to want to head up to that orange button to create a social post, and in here you want to choose a social network to get started on. In this case, I'm going to be publishing a blog onto Facebook. So we'll click on Facebook, and you can see in here that it outlines the specific social account that we're going to be scheduling from. In this case, we've got the right account, it's Neighbourhood. You can also see at the top some scheduling options. So here it has whether you want to publish right now or schedule for later. In the vast majority of cases, we'd recommend that you schedule the post for later, just to give you, even if it's a couple of minutes, just that time to ensure that the post is correct, to read it for grammar mistakes, anything like that. So even if it's 5 o'clock instead of 4:55, you'll be doing yourself a favor. So in here, you can select the date, whenever that may be, even next year, select the time. A really cool thing that HubSpot allows you to do and gives you is that it gives you default best practice times as well, based on when people are most likely to be on that channel. In this case, you can see it's 11:01, 2:01, and 4:46 p.m. You can then apply this. And then in here, this is where you actually build your post. So create an engaging post and connect with the world, as HubSpot says. So in here, it might be as simple as, please read our blog below, adding in a bit more context in there as well, obviously, about what the blog is about. And to be able to connect a blog here, I can go attach content, choose the content type, which, as I said, in this case is a blog post, choose the specific blog post, and then attach. That will then connect as such, and it will give you a preview of that article. It's also useful to be aware of the fact that you obviously don't just have the option to include blogs, you have the option to insert images as attachments, you can add in videos, you also have the option to insert emojis as well. As you can see here, ton of frequently used, there are a lot more in here than I remember. And that's as easy as it is. Once you've done that, then you can even press this plus button and it will actually copy all of your content in here to another platform. So if I wanted to post the same thing onto Instagram, I could just click on the Instagram button and it would automatically clone all of my content, which is super easy when you're looking to post bulk articles, for example, across numerous channels. So it's as easy as that. Once you're done, you can go down to schedule the post, ensure that there are no errors before you publish, or you can even save them as a draft. Especially if you're looking as a marketing coordinator, for example, you're looking to save them all as drafts and then send them to your marketing manager to approve. That's how I'd recommend that you do it. And there you have it. Now you know how to create and schedule a social post inside HubSpot. But if you're keen to really make the most from your HubSpot investment, Neighbourhood offer a step-by-step course covering marketing, sales, service, and the CMS Hub in depth, ensuring that you and your team are best serving your customers while offering efficient internal processes. We'll include a link for this below. As well, if you gleaned any value from this video or are keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget, if you're after a PDF version of this for later, or you're just passing it on to a mate in need, we'll include a link in the description.